Hi there, I'm Eric Wordweaver Sherbin, Gothi of the Ridgar Folk here in East Texas, and I'd like to welcome you to my channel, Wordweaver Productions. Now, most of you are probably familiar with my other show that I do, The Raven's Call, and some of you may remember a show that I've done in the past, which I intend to revive, but it takes a lot more prep time, and that's my Weaving Words show, where I go in and do some storytelling and things like that. Just kind of an update on that. I took a break on Weaving Words to work on my book that I'm writing. I have finished the book. It has gone out to edits and everything. I've actually gotten the edits back. So now I'm looking into publication. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I'm really hoping to have this sucker edited. Well, it's edited, but to have it published sometime this year. I gotta look at some stuff with illustrations and things like that. But anyway, this particular video that we're doing right here, right now, is an announcement trailer, guys. I am going to be doing some spin-off stuff. You guys, like I said, are familiar with some of my other episodes, my other shows, where I go on and do these specific things, you know? They're a little bit more serious. The storytelling thing is very hardcore about the storytelling aspects. The Raven's Call is very much rambly, meandering, but it's on specific subjects within heathenry or specific points that I want to make. And this is just going to be a fun little side that I'm going to do here and there. You know, Raven's Call has got a release schedule of every Wednesday at like 4 a.m. Central Standard Time in America. But I am looking at this particular project being something that's a little bit more laid back. All right, this is going to be something that occasionally I'm going to throw an episode up on. It's just a little extra kind of thing. Heck, I haven't even picked a name for what it's going to be yet. I'm actually thinking about pulling. Sorry, I'm shifting in my chair here. It's a different view in my office, obviously. Our normal filming spot's over there. So this is kind of what's behind my desk, because I can sit here, I can pull my computer up, I can pull up IMDb or whatever website I need to for some quick information and things like that in preparation for this video. And then I can look over here and reference it. So anyway, the idea is that I want to do a show, if I can quit rambling long enough to tell you guys, I want to do a show where I review different things in media, okay? This could be books, this could be movies, this could be video games, whatever it is, but I'm still going to kind of keep it around a heathen perspective, all right? It's going to be a heathen's view on these media. So I'm going to look at some movies, especially, I love B-rate, like Viking movies, horrible movies that are absolutely fantastic, or horrible movies that are absolutely horrible. I'm also going to look at some really good ones too. The idea being that I want to look at them for heathen values, ethics, things like that that might be present. I also want to just kind of review them from a heathen's perspective of, you know, somebody might look at this and go, oh, this is a great Viking movie and it's awesome. And I'm sitting here going, that's crap. That's horrible. I don't like it. It's ridiculous. It's, you know, historical inaccuracies aside, it's just not fun. That kind of thing. Or one of them where it's like, oh, look, they reference Odin like 20 times, but nobody actually gets it, you know. Things like the Robert Zemeckis Beowulf. I'm definitely going to be doing that one at some point in time. I've got some gems tucked away in my DVD cabinet at home that I really, really, really want to talk about and get out there, because I think you guys need to at least know about these things, okay? For the purposes of copyright and all of that, I'm not going to be using clips from the movies. I'm just going to be talking about them. I will use splashes to show you kind of some images of the movie. Probably just the splash coming in to show you the movie itself, and then I'll talk about it, talk about the cast and everything. Again, it's going to be a lot of talking head stuff, but quite honestly, most of you guys listen to my stuff. You don't actually watch it anyway, so it doesn't really matter. You know, like Brandon rolling down the road isn't going to have a clue that I changed my camera angle, except for the fact that I told you all, because the cat doesn't actually watch my videos. He listens to them. Same for most folks, and I'm fine with that. You know, it works. That's part of the reason I do the format that I do. If I ever get my hands on a decent laptop again, I will look at possibly rolling my entire library over to podcast and rolling it out that way. But the way it is right now on my phone, that has been somewhat prohibitive. Okay? So anyway, the idea is I want to look at video games, movies, music, things like that, whatever. To put a spotlight on some of these things, I'd like to be able to showcase and spotlight some heathen artists when I can find them. I would love to be able to spotlight some specific movie things, which, that being said, Send me recommendations, guys. Jump on the Facebook page, Word-Weaver Productions. Jump on the Facebook page. You'll find the link to it down in the the description below. Jump in there and give me recommendations on movies to review, okay? Because I'm going to be doing some. Definitely going to be jumping in there. Video games is a little bit more difficult because they are more expensive. Netflix, I can jump on there and I can get a disc in, and that's no big deal, you know? There's certain things that I can watch online without a problem. More than happy to sit down because I love watching movies. I love movies. I was a theater kid growing up in high school and everything. Did a whole bunch of theater, bunch of Ren Faire stuff. So I've always had kind of an acting bug with that. Gee, go figure. I do a YouTube channel now. And with all of that, I like to critique kind of the art that is at play here, but also from a heathen's perspective, I'm constantly critiquing things. Like I sat down and watched a movie just the other day that really hit home for me on some heathen values. Just, wow, it was right up there, just plastered. I actually jumped on the phone and texted my buddy Mike. I was like, dude, have you seen this movie? It is just rife with heathen stuff. The tribal aesthetic, the tribal mechanics, everything. It is spot on and it's fantastic. So I'm going to jump into some of those when I see them. Sometimes they might not be Viking-related movies. They may not be, you know, set in a particular aesthetic of either Viking or Northern European settings, whatever. There's some absolutely fantastic animated films I know of that have got some key examples of some absolutely heathen worldview philosophies, things like that. Like ones I can look at and say, holy monkeys, they get the Vaytir spot on, you know. If you look at this movie over here, they get the genus loci thing going on hardcore. There's like so many movies where I just geek out about different heathen things like hearth cult. Oh, I love seeing hearth cult pop up in a movie. So you can look at movies that aren't necessarily heathen and they'll be just full of heathen stuff. So that's my goal. That's what I'm shooting for, is to let you guys see these things and to kind of offer my take on a few of these things. I'm going to be working the kinks out on the formatting and everything as I go along. Luckily, I've got a lot of experience with The Raven's Call now. We're up in the 80s on my episode numbers there. But you know, I'm going to be figuring out the mechanics on this particular thing because I'm not sure exactly how I want to do it yet. I may still include some blooper stuff at the end, just if I happen to have something funny that comes up in it. But my goal is to keep these shorter, more bite-sized, because nobody wants to sit and listen to me talk for 30, 45 minutes on one movie. You know, 10, 15 minutes, that's fine. But, you know, going for a whole, you know, full Raven's Call episode, like, length, I seriously doubt anybody wants to hear that much. But we'll see. You guys will tell me. I'll get the feedback both in the comments and on Facebook. You're welcome to comment with movies and stuff here down below in the comments section. That's fine. I don't have a problem with that. I would prefer the Facebook group. Please, that is actually my preferred method of gathering that information because it's easier for me to go back to and pull up. I will create a thread for recommendations of media reviews, okay? So, at some point in time here in the near future, I think that's how I'm going to go about it. Because people are going to want to give their own reviews of movies and like, hey, what's this? It's fantastic. It's amazing. And blah, 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 blah. We'll get to that point. I want to get a few of these out first with my take on it so you guys can see where I'm coming from and how I view things. But I do want to hear what you guys have. I want to see these movies that I may not have seen. I guarantee you, for the most part, if it's a big budget Viking film, I have probably seen it. No, I'm not completely caught up on Vikings yet. I live out in the boondocks. I don't have television, so I'm having to do it via DVD. And we had to lay off after about season 3, simply because we moved on to something else for a little bit. Plan to go back. Just haven't yet. We'll get there. I'm not caught up on Game of Thrones yet either. So that's that. I'm staying spoiler-free on that is extremely difficult. But I'm pulling most of it off. There's a few that have snuck through that I don't. But anyway, the gist is, I think this is going to be fun. I'm interested to see where it goes, and I'm looking forward to kind of interacting with you guys and seeing if this is something you're interested in. If you like my viewpoints on this, if you like the insights and kind of fun things, it's just supposed to be fun. That's all. It's kind of a neat thing. I was sitting there watching a movie with Twyla the other day. Twyla's my significant other, if you don't know, the lady of my hall. And we watched a movie, and I'm like, oh, this is amazing. I have to review it for the YouTube channel. Got to. It's going to be a lot of fun. So that's actually going to be the first one we do here in the next episode. The movie is Alpha, so you guys can look forward to that. I'm going to drop this teaser trailer up on the YouTube channel so you guys can know what to expect. And can kind of give me some feedback there. I may do a poll on the YouTube, on the Facebook group about the title. We'll see. I'm kind of looking into that. I'm going to toy around with a few ideas title-wise today. I'm also going to play with the format and everything. Kind of comfortable in the setting. I think it's going to work. I may continue to work with this particular spacing. We'll see. I'm working with it. Okay. So, without any further ado, I'm going to cut this one off today. But thank you guys for your continued support. As of the filming of this particular teaser trailer, we are at 1,179 subscribers. That is crazy. I did not think I would ever hit those kind of numbers. And so I really hope I can put out stuff that you guys will be interested in and will keep you guys coming back. So please jump on the Facebook group or in the comments below, whatever. Give me recommendations for the Raven's Call, things you want to hear me talk about. I'm going to stay away from some of the more either everybody's done them kind of things. Like, for instance, I don't go through and do just a let's read the Havamal thing. There's tons of people that are out there doing it. The Asa Truman Show right now, that's what he's going through and doing is a reading of the Havamal. I think Jesse's done it over on Midgard's Musings. A bunch of people have done readings of the Havamal, Voluspa, things like that. And that's here and there. It's a good thing. It's fantastic. I'm glad people are doing that. That doesn't mean that I need to do it because it's already been done kind of thing, you know? So that's why I do like my classes and things like that I do. So anyway, I'm rambling. So we're going to kill it here. Thank you guys. Please continue to support the channel. I don't beg for money on the channel. I don't even have anything set up for you guys to send money. So that should prove that I just do this because I like to do it. So please continue to feed the channel with likes, subscriptions, comments, things like that. Jump in there. Let's interact with each other. Please keep it civil. I did have to shut down an argument that got going the other day because, you know, trolls in the comments on one of my YouTube videos. It was kind of sad because it started out with something that could have been an interesting conversation and ended up being just trolling. And it was disappointing. I think there may have been a language barrier in there somewhere. Anyway. I don't know. It's a thing. So, thank you guys. Look forward to more episodes here in the future, and we'll name the sucker at some point in time. I probably won't have one by the time I film the first episode, because I'm probably about to film the first episode in about 45 seconds. So, we'll see. Anyway, thank you guys. Hail. May your ancestors smile on you.